Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we are going to talk about ComfyUI custom nudes, which got released in the month of May 2024. Now, there are a lot of custom nudes, around, I believe, 60, 62. So I will not be able to cover all of them. Also, I will not be able to go into greater detail explaining how to install or set it up on your system. Instead, for today's video, I'm going to go and provide you with an overview of the one which I found interesting. I will leave a link in the description below to the complete list, and you can check out the individual custom nudes at your own pace. Let's get started. Image editing and manipulation nudes. Let's start with ComfyUI Photopea. This is basically the online Photoshop web application, but inside of ComfyUI. The extension creates an iframe and places Photopea on top of ComfyUI and automatically copies the input image to Photopea. You can use it to make your edits inside this one. Click on the Save to Node button. This brings you back into ComfyUI where you can continue editing with your workflow. Now, important to note, the Photopea editor is available inside the load image node or any input image node. It is not available for the preview or the save node. Next is ComfyUI layers, which gives you a layers saver node. You can use the segment anything method or any other method to segment your images into different layers and then save all of them as a PSD file. This makes it compatible with Photoshop or even Photopea. There are other tools or programs which can also open PSD files. Now, let's talk about ComfyUI layer divider. Similar to what we just talked, this is another set of custom nodes that you can use to divide an image into individual layers and save it as a PSD file. Next one is size match compositing node. When you have two images, this node can help determine the final size of the image if the image sizes don't match. When trying to use the default composite node, you might get an error. This node takes the two images and uses different methods like the cover crop, center crop, and others to composite the image. Next, we have ComfyUI Auto Trim Background. This node trims the background, leaving only the main subject. It is similar to the options available inside Krita or Photoshop, where you can trim a layer to a current selection. Creative image generation and stylization. Next, let's talk about Toon Crafter. It's a research paper that can take a starting frame and an ending frame. It interpolates between the two frames. For example, if the hair in the starting frame is slightly moving, the model will generate that movement for you. One thing to note is that it requires a lot of VRAM. If you're using the original Toon Crafter GitHub repository project, you will require around 26 gigabytes of VRAM. There is an easier ComfyUI version. Right now, it does not offer a lot of options and it can only do the basic interpolation from a starting to an ending frame. But as tested by the author using an RTX 4090, it can generate images in around 26 seconds. Now note that the original Toon Crafter repository has different modes. The basic one goes from starting to end frame. Another mode is to take an input sketch for guidance. Now probably in a future video, I'm going to cover this one in greater detail. Next one is ComfyUI Mosaica. It lets you create colorful mosaic images. It gives you a lookup table like to apply different effects to the output image. It's interesting and can add character and style to your final image. Next, we have StyleGAN. You may have heard of GAN or Generative Adversarial Network. It's a research paper that gives another way of creating images. This one is well documented. For the ComfyUI custom node, it adds support for StyleGAN 2 and StyleGAN three models. Next, we have the ComfyUI Instant Style. I covered this one in a previous video where I showed you how to implement the same thing using ControlNet and IP adapter. The idea is to apply style in different layers in the network. Now we have a ComfyUI extension. It is very basic right now, but you can test it out to see how it works for you. Now next is ComfyUI Universal Styler. It uses AI to style your images. We also have ComfyUI SDXS Style Preview, which gives you a preview when selecting a style. It's a nice visual accessibility option. Assisted Image Processing. Next is ComfyUI Auto Label. It labels any image you pass to it. This one uses blip to generate the captions for the image. Now, if you want to do the reverse, going from an image to text, there is a custom node for that. It's called Image to Text ComfyUI node. It takes an image as an input and outputs text similar to blip. The main idea though is to use a large language model to generate the text. If you have the system requirements, you can ask questions and generate a prompt based on those questions. Next, we have a node to crop faces based on the sliders and shift factor. It will crop the image to just the face. You can use this to upscale or add more detail or even correct the face. It uses Retina Face for detection. If you already have a node using Retina Face, you might get the same result. Advanced Image Processing Techniques. Next is for Inpainting. If you need a way to crop or stitch images together, you can use the ComfyUI Inpaint Crop and Stitch node. The author has a video on YouTube you can watch to see how to use it. Next one is ProPainter Project. This one is quite popular, so you may already know that you can use it to remove objects in videos or complete images. Now there's a ComfyUI implementation, so you can use ProPainter inside of ComfyUI. For example, we have a subject. It's tracking the subject, creating a mask, and removing that subject. Specialized functionality nodes. Next one is ComfyUI Pose Key Point Mask. It can convert pose key points to a mask. If you're into animation, you may want to check this one out. Once you have the mask, you can blur, you can composite it on top of another image, giving you more control over the final output. Wave to Lip. This is another lip syncing custom node. It takes an input video and an audio file. It generates a lip sync output video using that input video and audio file. Next is the ComfyUI Light Gradient. You can use this node to create gradients for your final image generation. If you want the sun to shine from one direction, you can create a gradient that goes from yellow to transparent or white and then overlay it on your image to get that effect. There are other uses to color grade your image for artistic style as well. Next one is AnyLine. It's a new line detection preprocessor for detail line extraction. If you're using ControlNet and line preprocessors, give this one a try. You can see the examples to see how detailed it is. Utility and helper nodes. Next one involves saving generated images using ComfyUI extended image formats. It gives you the ability to save images in formats like WebP, JPEG, and so on. It also has support for embedding the metadata into the workflow, similar to the default ComfyUI behavior. Here's another node for saving images. It is similar to the last one, allows you to customize folders, subfolders, file names, and different file extensions. Next is for the image feed. You can see at the bottom, if you have the Python, GUS, SSS, ComfyUI custom script extension, you already have this one. But if you do not want to install the full package and just want the feed component, you can install this ComfyUI Simple Feed custom node. Common projects. Now next is a custom nude by Ilyas Veal. You may already know this person as they already created quite a few models. Omost, a new way of prompting and generating images, which works well, but has high VRAM requirements, around 8 gigabytes. There's also a ComfyUI custom node being developed to use Omost inside of ComfyUI. By the time you're watching this video, it's possible that it's already out. Now, basically, it uses large language model to generate prompts in a code format. You can check out his repository here. It is really good. Now for ComfyUI, we are talking about the IC Lite custom node. There's a native implementation for the project, which allows you to light up your images in creative ways. Next is the ComfyUI Stylize PhotoMZ, which gives you controls to style your final image. Next one is Story Diffusion. It can create a story by generating consistent images and videos. It will try to maintain the character images consistent for long sequences. There is a ComfyUI version available on GitHub. Next is ComfyUI Story Creator. The author used a dataset to generate a short story using a fine-tuned model. Note that using the base model won't yield the same result, but the dataset is available for fine tuning. Next one is PuLID for ComfyUI. It's another face model, so it allows you to take an input image and generate an output image using that face. Matteo from the Latent Vision YouTube channel has already released a video on this project. Next is HiDiffusion. This has been covered by a lot of content creators, so you can check out any videos or documentation out there. For ComfyUI users, we now have an extension for it. Next one is the ComfyUI LoRa Tuner. It is a convenient way of chaining multiple LoRas together. You can mix and match different LoRas, control their intensity, and manage them all in one node. Next, we have Image Vector for ComfyUI. It will convert your images to a vector image. Next one is the ComfyUI Translate node. It uses Bing to translate from other languages to English. If English is not your primary language, you may want to type in your prompt in your language and use this node to translate to English. Now finally, we have a project that provides a group of custom nodes which gives some quality of life options. These include a prompt selector, image resizer, mask creation, multiple mask creation and resizing, image tiling, random mask creation and more. All right, that is it for today's video. I hope you found some interesting or cool looking project that you can test out. Let me know in the comments down below if I should cover any of these custom nodes in greater detail, going through the installation, setup, and workflows. If you've reached this point in the video, big thank you to you. YouTube says that only 13% of viewers reach the end of the video. So if you're part of those 13%, thank you. I really appreciate it. That's it. I'll see you in the next one.